Hey, how's it going, everybody? I'm sure that when you played Fallout 4 for the first time in vanilla, when you came across the weapon known as the Syringer, you were pretty excited. It was a very unique and very Fallout-styled weapon, one made completely out of scrap, with the unique ability to use air pressure to fire its projectiles, and it had very customizable projectiles. You could swap out ammo types to do a variety of different types of damage, or have different status effects applied to your enemies or even allies. Altogether, it was a very unique weapon, one with a lot of promise. Yet, in function, it wasn't actually that great. To tell the truth, it was a bit of a limp noodle, and in vanilla, the Syringer is pretty much worthless. You couldn't really make a build around it, and altogether, it was just kind of garbage. But today, we're fixing that with a wonderful mod known as SRO, the Syringer Overhaul by Cosmonaut. This is going to give not only a complete facelift to the Syringer, but also change its functionality greatly through the use of attachments at the weapon's workbench, and overall just give a complete overhaul to this weapon to make it absolutely amazing. Now the Syringer is a completely viable option and it looks great too. As the author puts it, it turns a pure abomination into an elegant piece of metal, and I gotta say I couldn't agree more. I stayed away from the Syringer completely, and even when people recommended this mod to me, I still stayed away because I knew at its core it would be a Syringer, but this mod does a great job of turning it into something actually viable, actually usable, and honestly just a fun weapon to have. The only thing that's missing after this is having some perks to go with it to make it more in line with the other vanilla options, but even with just this mod, the Syringer is something that's worth picking up now, and it's just a lot of fun to use. So with that, let's go ahead and jump right into what you're going to get with this mod. For starters, let's start off with the simple stuff. This mod gives a new enhanced look to the Syringer by using vanilla assets and remeshing them to give it a nice new modified design. It's also going to modify some of the firing sounds. It's going to give it some nice new textures as well as completely new paint jobs that you can apply at the weapon's workbench. Another really interesting thing when it comes to the visuals of this mod is that since there are also creation kit paint jobs and there are vanilla assets on this weapon, if you use a creation kit paint job, it could be different from the paint jobs already supplied in this mod, meaning you could mix match paint jobs. You could throw on two gunner paint jobs or throw on half Brotherhood of Steel, half Institute. You could really mix and match them to get some really unique color designs that you like. But when it comes to the heavy stuff, the real things that make this weapon different from the vanilla, we do have new modifications like the pressure system, laser and flashlight attachments, infusions, and more attachments that just completely change the way the weapon functions. Things like infusions are going to change elemental damages, whereas pressure systems are just going to make it do more damage in general and increase things like range. There is the addition of a completely new unique Syringer, something that didn't exist in the vanilla game, which is pretty neat. On top of the Syringer weapon itself, the author has also enhanced a bunch of the vanilla syringe ammo types, as well as added a couple of new ones. The power of your syringes will now also depend on the chemist perk, so with higher levels of the chemist perk, you can craft more potent syringe ammo types, which is pretty awesome. And one of the last features, even though it sounds like a small one, is one that I appreciate a lot. All of the syringe ammo types can now be purchased in medical shops. Typically with a Syringer, you'd have to craft all of your ammo, and that was kind of a big drawback to me. I didn't want to have to visit a chemistry station every time I needed to top off on ammo, especially if I didn't have the supplies. Now you can just go buy the ammo from medical shops, just like you would buy ammo from Arturo. This is an excellent, excellent addition, and I think it makes the weapon much more viable and much more usable. Now, because of the way that most of these features were implemented, this mod is compatible with pretty much everything, except of course mods that altered the Syringer itself. But even things like retextures will apply perfectly fine. For example, I'm using Gmoy's retexture of the pipe weapons, and so some of those textures will be applied here. But it's all compatible, everything just works. Now, where this mod really shines is definitely over at the weapons workbench, as that's where all of the really neat features are going to be applied. And so I figured, much like we would treat a weapon review, let's go ahead and go through all of the attachments available in this overhaul, as they are all pretty unique and very different from the vanilla experience. Here you can see a standard version of what the Syringer will look like now with this mod installed. It's not too far from the original Syringer. You can definitely see where it came from, but there are some pretty notable differences. And if we look at some of the ones that I've made already, you can see here we have a heavily modified Institute variant that is converted to shoot acid. And then we have a Brotherhood of Steel one here that has some laser infusion. We have a Railroad Plasma version and even a Minutemen Cryo Syringer. So you can do some pretty crazy stuff. Let's go ahead and grab a regular short Syringer. And actually, let's go back for 1 second. Notice over here at the stats, we just see for the regular short syringer, we have the injectable, we have no damage stat, we have a fire rate of 2. This is all pretty standard. This is what you would expect in a vanilla version of the syringer. But when we look at something like our marksman's syringer here, we have a base damage of 78, an energy damage of 40, and a fire rate of 7, not 2. So, pretty interesting. So, like I said, let's go ahead and grab our short version and see what we can do. Starting with the barrels, this is a pretty simple section. We have the stub barrel with a shroud, the short shrouded, the long, and the long shrouded barrels, which are just going to mess with range and accuracy for the most part. Then we have stocks, which are pretty standard as well, with a standard stock, a marksman stock, and a recoil compensating stock, my favorite of which being the marksman stock. It just looks really nice on this weapon. For sights, we have a handful of sights, including the standard iron sights that we're used to, the reflex tactical sight, which will put on the Gatling laser reflex, but it's been modified a little bit. We have the standard glow sights, the short scope, the reflex sight, the reflex glow sight, which will be the reflex sight seen on things like the combat rifle. We then have the medium scope, long scope, short night vision scope, medium night vision scope, long night vision scope, the short recon scope, and the long recon scope. Not too much going on there in the scope section besides the nice variety of reflex sights to choose from, which is nice. But here's something completely new. We have laser sights. We have our standard laser sight, which is nothing. But then we also have our blue, green, and red laser sights, which will provide a corresponding laser color. And then we also have here at the top the targeting computer, which, as you see, puts a nice little device on the side of your weapon there that has a screen and a camera at the front. And this is going to allow your projectiles to seek their targets, though it's going to make the projectile speed slower so you can actually seek said targets. If it was going too fast, it would just zoom right past them and the targeting computer would do nothing. So pretty interesting. It suits just about every build, but it's pretty nice. If you don't want to have to aim for yourself, having a targeting computer is pretty neat. Then we have what is known as the carcass paint. This is going to be the built-in paint options if you don't have any of the Creation Club stuff. We have standard black, which is going to be a nice cleaned up version of the weapon. We then have Brotherhood, Institute, Minutemen, Nuka-Cola, Quantum Cola, Railroad, and Standard, which is just going to use my G-Moyes retexture, and then Vault-Tec and White. Moving on, we also have a flashlight section, which will add a flashlight over to the right side of the weapon here. You see we have a mounted mag light, which is pretty cool. And from there, we have the standard blue, the bright purple, red, and Vault Boy. So your pretty standard flashlight options that you would see on things like power armor. We then have some more of the interesting stuff with the firing mechanism. Here's the standard mechanism, which is going to be just the break action reload that we're used to. But then we have the semi-auto modification, which will allow you to continue firing your projectiles much, much faster, though it is going to reduce the effectiveness by 30% of all of your syringes. So it's kind of a trade-off there. Then we have our infusions, which will allow you to add in acid, cryo, laser, or plasma infusions. Something I really appreciate is that these all do change the visuals of the weapon. As you can see, acid throws on a lot of green bits and parts onto the weapon here. Cryo will throw on some cryo cells, laser will throw on some fusion cells, and then plasma will throw on some plasma cells. Pretty neat stuff. And that's going to change some of the damage of the weapon. We also have the pressure. We have standard, medium, and high compression. This is going to add base ballistic damage to the weapon, so you're actually hurting people with the pressure of your syringes being fired, which is pretty crazy. We then have the chemical module. This is going to have standard, advanced, powerful, and powerful shroudless. And this is going to change the potency of your syringes. So pretty cool stuff to make your syringes even more powerful. And I suppose if we're going to be showing off every feature in this mod, we should also talk about the newly added ammo types. So we'll head over to the Syringer ammo section of the chemistry station, and you'll find all of the new and classic syringes with modified stats. We have things that you're used to like Bleed Out and Danger All, Mind Cloud, but we also have new things like Ram and Slam, which is a simple, cheap, but heavy syringe, which actually hits them with ballistic blunt damage. The description says that this is the best choice for people who are not invested into science or chemistry, but just want to get some raw damage out of their syringes. So this is going to fire a nice heavy syringe. We have some other things like Yellow Belly, Bloatfly Larva, Blood Bug Larva. Hibernation is a really neat one. It disables nearby mechanical targets for some time. Taking the perk Robotics Expert can further expand the duration from 10 seconds to 40 seconds. which is pretty crazy. So it actually has some synergy with other perks in the game. And you have a Jailbreak, which will remotely hack mechanical targets like robots or turrets. Not sure how that works, but it is still pretty neat. We then have Pharma Prince, which will, upon hit, heal wounds and increase damage resistance, which will be great for your allies. Torchlight is going to deal massive fire damage to the target and ignite everyone around it. Again, scientifically, don't know how that works, but it does make this weapon much more viable. And then we go on with other things like Berserk and Blizzard, which will instantly freeze the target. Hijack is going to have mechanical targets go frenzy and will overload them if they are at maximum health and movement speed. Then we have Party Starter, which upon hit is going to have everybody go crazy, start dancing, and annoy everybody around them. So yeah, that one's just more of a bit of fun, but still pretty cool. We then have something pretty unique like Boomer, which is going to have an explosive device inside of it so that it will explode on impact. And having higher Demolition Expert will increase the blast radius of that. Ghoulification is going to deal some massive radiation damage. Heavy Metal is going to overcharge the Fusion Core system in Power Armor suits, which will immediately put them into Meltdown, making this a very powerful anti-Power Armor weapon. It's worth taking a Syringer just for that effect alone, especially on harder survival difficulties where Power Armor is a serious threat. One of my favorites, known as the Gym Dandy, is going to do shock damage, and it will also release a shockwave if it is an organic target. Mechanical targets and Power Armor are going to take even more damage from this because they are weak to shock damage. We have some pretty unique utility syringes as well, like X-Ray, which will, upon hitting the target, scan and detect everyone through obstacles and barriers, which makes this a pretty nice recon tool. And then we have Sugar Bomb, which is going to overload the victim with endorphins. They're going to lose their head from happiness. So they're just going to be pretty goofy. But yeah, overall, the Syringer now has a ton of utility and some serious damage potential that it did not have before, and it makes the Syringer a seriously viable weapon, either as a tool or as an actual damage dealer. I think this is a great weapon to pair with a Railroad character, especially since there is a Railroad skin in this, as it's pretty stealth-focused and can be used to do some pretty nasty things to your enemies while hiding in the shadows. Overall, I think this is a great one to try out, and you can try it out not only on PC, but Xbox as well. I'll have links to both down in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to drop a rating. Big shout out, as always, to my patrons for making videos like this possible. Thanks for your continued support every single day. You guys are awesome. If you want to check out the Patreon yourself, we offer things like early access to my mods and exclusive Discord roles, but it is completely optional. With that, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you're somehow not subscribed already, consider subscribing, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Peace!